Hi friends, I am Karthikeyan and this is class on heterocyclic compounds. See, in this class we are going to discuss about heterocyclic compounds. So we should know what are heterocyclic compounds. So I have written the definition of heterocyclic compounds at this corner. See, a heterocyclic compound is a 5 or 6 membered ring compound with at least one hetero atom as a ring member. And these are relatively stable and exhibit aromatic characters. These are nothing but heterocyclic compounds. It means, see, if I consider, I should give the example for heterocyclic compound. See, this is one example for heterocyclic compounds, because in the ring there is a hetero atom. Hetero atom may be nitrogen, oxygen, sulfur, phosphorus, we may get anything. These are hetero atoms. This should be present in a ring. And this is good example for heterocyclic compounds. And these are relatively stable. These are stable because of resonance. And these are aromatic. As I have explained in previous class, these are aromatic because 2, 4, 6. Because of 6 pi electrons, these are aromatic. This is good example for heterocyclic compound. The next example is this one. Consider this. Here the hetero atom is oxygen, and this is also aromatic, and this is also stable, and this is a hetero atom. Consider this one. This is also a good example for heteroatomic compounds. These are the three good examples for heterocyclic compounds. Let me consider this. This is also a hetero atom. And this is also a good example for heterocyclic compounds. See this one. Oh, nitrogen is here. This is also a good example for heterocyclic compounds. So see, here in all the cyclic compounds there is one or the other hetero atom. There should be at least one hetero atom. There may be hetero atom may be of two. If this consider this compound, this is also a heterocyclic compound, but here we have two hetero atoms. This consists of two hetero atoms, but all these are aromatic. See, here we have 6 pi electrons, but here we have 10 pi electrons. This is good example for type 10 pi electrons, and this is also a 10 pi electron system. These two are 10 pi electron system. This is 6 pi electron system. So this is also a heterocyclic, and these are aromatic. And one more compound, let me take like this. See, here also we have 6 pi electrons, and these are two hetero atoms, and it is aromatic. So these are good examples for heterocyclic compounds. So then how to name these compounds? So we should know nomenclature. To know nomenclature, you need to remember these things. Let me write some of the points here so that you can remember. If the hetero atom consists, the heterocyclic compound consists of oxygen. Oxygen as hetero atom, you need to tell it as oxa. Oxa, you need to say. If sulfur is present in heterocyclic compound, then you need to say thaya. Thaya stands for sulfur. And aza stands for nitrogen. Aza stands for nitrogen. And if phosphor is present in the cycle, then it should be phospha. This you need to remember in order to give their names. If compound is 5 members, see, this compound is 5 members. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Since it is 5 members, if compound is 5 members, then you need to say ole. if the compound is 6 membered, then in. If compound is 7 membered, then you should say if in. If you know these things, you can nomenclature, you can give name for few compounds. See, this here it is 5 numbered, so you need to tell ole, since nitrogen group is there, as. So this is azole, as ole. This is, since oxygen is there, oxole, oxole. Sulfur is there, thiole, thiole. And see, here two heteroatoms. How to give preference? Which atom should be given first? Numbering. So, for numbering, we should know that oxygen, if oxygen is there, for that, the preference should be 1, followed by sulfur, followed by nitrogen, finally, phosphorus. This is the preference. Preference should be given to oxygen, later sulfur, nitrogen and phosphorus. So here nitrogen should be, sulfur and nitrogen, sulfur should be given first preference. So thi, us, nitrogen, us, it is 5 membered, so ole. Thi, us, ole. See here oxygen, nitrogen, oxygen should be given first preference, so ox, nitrogen, us, ole. Ox, us, ole. These are the nomenclature. But in regular or in our class, we discuss about their not IPAC nomenclature, we discuss their common nomenclature. That is common name we refer. That as we move with these videos, we will get them. So in our syllabus, that is in our basic study, we have this azole. This is known as pyrrole, common name. Oxole, furan, we need to study these two. Thiole, we should study. We are not going to study these compounds, but I have some other compounds to study. Let me write their names. We need to study about this kind of compounds. This is benzene, here I have. This is indole. We need to study this, their preparation and their chemical properties and their structure, we need to study. This is phenolene, we need to study this also. And this is isophenolene. This is isophenolene. We need to study these compounds. Here I want a double bond, like that bond will be like this. This is phenolene, isophenolene and indole. These are there for our syllabus, their preparation. As we move with the videos, you are going to get about those compounds. And the numbering, you should know about how to number these compounds. So the numbering, see, if I take furan, this is furan, oxole is a furan. Here, see, the first number should be given to a heteroatom. In anti-clockwise, we number like this. This is the numbering. We should write heteroatom downside and one should be given to heteroatom in anti-clockwise direction. This is anti-clockwise. Like that, we should number. If I consider this, the compound is, that is phenolene. If I consider phenolene, see, this is structure of phenolene. First number should be given to heteroatom in anti-clockwise direction, we are going to 4. 5 we should not write here, but 5 is here. 5, 6, 7 and 8. This is the numbering of this heteroatoms, that is in anticlockwise. This is all about nomenclature and what are heterocyclic compounds. In next class, we shall discuss about one by one. First, we shall discuss about furan, its preparation, its chemical properties and its electrophilic reactions, etc. Then we will move with this next compounds. Till then, please take care of yourself, read well and have a good day. Thank you.